The team from Swamp Inc. is checking stagnant, shallow pools in search of mosquito larvae to treat with a natural bacterium.
A ditch that long, full of water, that ditch is probably 200 feet long, 3 feet wide, you can have hundreds of thousands of mosquito larvae.
Of the 40-plus species of mosquitoes in New Hampshire, only about 5 are known to carry insect-borne diseases. It's their habitats they monitor year-round, but especially after a period of rain followed by warm weather, and not always in places you'd expect.
Urban areas have lots of street catch basins. They're stagnant water habitats, and unfortunately they produce a lot of mosquitoes called culex that are really bad for West Nile virus. The woodland pools in red maple swamps are problems for a mosquito called Melanura, which is the primary vector for Triple E. It's a mosquito that doesn't bite people. It's a bird feeder, but it's the mosquito that amplifies Triple E in a local area.
This season isn't starting out too bad. A snowy winter gave way to a dry spring, but the lack of a hard freeze has helped the Triple E mosquito, who can survive the winter in cavities under root systems. The salt marsh is home to bridge vectors who bite birds and mammals, spreading disease between the two. Those worries peak in late summer. The worries now are with ticks. Give me a sense of how bad it is.
Very, very bad.
The nymphal stage right now carries a high percentage of Lyme disease. Advice, tick checks, and the monitoring of habitats. In Portsmouth, Jennifer Crompton, WMUR News 9.